short Induspasser. My name is Christoph Jentsch. It's actually my sixth DevCon I'm speaking. And I'm the CEO of Slockers. And for those of you who have followed us a little bit, we have recently been acquired by Blockchains LLC. That's why for the first time you will see actually fancy slides from me and not boring developer slides. So now we have a designer looking over this. And we are going to, I just want to show you now what our current roadmap is. You know from us that we have worked on the Universal Share Network, you have known from us that we are working on InCube. About InCube, there will be a presentation tomorrow in the room B9 at 3:15. So, but I will show you just how this all fits together now and how the tech stack is looking. So, that's what I mean with fancy. So you know blockchain has acquired several bunkers across the world. Europe, US, and maybe some more. And so what one service will provide is actually custodian keys, as you heard from other custody services before. So custodian keys means we have an analog cold wallet, a digital cold wallet, as well as a hot wallet. Hot wallet using special signatures, multi-party computation. So when people set up their wallet, some do want it to be their own bank and some don't. For those who don't, who want to give the private keys to others as a custodian, we want to offer this service. I think it's mostly being used for recovery. Of course, there's more than the custody keys. There will still be those keys which a user is owning by themselves, which we would call, of course, the user-owned keys. Right now you would use, for example, a mobile wallet, or your hardware wallet, or key file, as you do before. So those are the types of keys which exist. And of course, they need to go together now in a multi-sig wallet. In multi-sig, we are currently looking at different variants, like a Gnosis, Safe Wallet, and others. Also, the multi-sig still being used by the Ethereum Foundation, which I worked on in 2015. And then multi-sig, you can have all the security features, such as data limits, with swallow whitelist, co-signing keys, recovery keys, and so on. But you're able to configure it in a way which fits your needs. For example, I might say I want to own all the keys by myself. I'm only using those user-owned keys or my own keys in this multisig. Or my mom maybe would say, I let all those keys stored by Blockchain LLC. Some of you may say, I choose something in the middle. I keep control of it. I have, let's say, 3 out of 5 multisig, and I store 4 or 3 out of those keys, and the others I let store by a custodian. You still have the safety of, in the case you lose your keys, you still can access your funds, but still you're completely in control. For example, you can put in something we call a dead man switch, that we could basically challenge the keys you own if you don't sign within a certain time frame, like a couple of months, then the custody key gets access to the funds. So a lot of nice things can be done in this multisig. Those are the features I just mentioned. Of course, the multisig will hold those Ethereum-based assets and also wrapped assets, just as Bitcoin, or the W Bitcoin. The nice thing is now for the hot wallet, the security feature, the only way to access the hot wallet will be through an event on the public Ethereum chain. So only if those criteria have been met on the multisig, then you actually see something happening on the public chain. On top of this, we are building an SDK. At the core of this will be the InCube client, which you already know. It's a minimal verification client, which is similar to a Lite client, but not connected to the peer-to-peer network. We also will give developers access to our custody service, the custody SDK. We will have a payment interface, as well as an IoT access interface, which you currently know from the Universal Share Network, that you can connect something like a smart door lock or another IoT device, which will listen to what happens on a smart contract. And we also are building an identity and reputation system, which we all offer through our SDK to developers. On top of this SDK, of course, you can build apps. This is what I would call the third-party applications. And those applications have this nice feature that they can be highly integrated with the multisig, meaning the multisig address can be the owning something on your side of the third-party app, which is unique for a custody solution. And of course, on the other side, we are also building in-house apps, financial applications, and others. And on top of this, there will be a user interface. You maybe can compare it a bit like Google settings or Apple settings, because in this user interface, you actually can do all the key management, like managing your multisig settings, your digital assets, except in rechecking signing requests. So from third-party apps, there could be some signing requests that you can accept or recheck. And also your identity management, like credentials or permissions of credentials attestations. So this is the whole tech stack we are building. with the goal of basically having a full stack, having the optimal developer experience and building on top of this SDK, plus the safety which comes with the custody solution. Thank you for your attention.